Hi, in this video, we are going to discuss about how to find highest normal form of a relation. So this is an important topic from GATE exam point of view. Before understanding this topic, you should have idea about how to find attribute closure and candidate keys and what are the various normal forms of a relation. For understanding these topics, you can refer these links. So we will see how to find highest normal form of a relation. To find highest normal form of a relation, first you have to find out all possible candidate keys of the relation. So you will be given a relation and functional dependency is in that relation. You have to find all possible candidate keys. Then you have to divide the attributes into two categories. One is prime attribute, another is non-prime attribute. Prime attributes are those attributes which are part of candidate key and non-prime are others. Then you have to check for first normal form. If it is satisfies first normal form, then second normal form, then third normal form. So if it does not satisfy third normal form, the highest normal form will be lower than this. That means second normal form. So we will see some examples to find the highest normal form of a relation. You have been given a relation R with attributes A, B, C, D, E, and these are the FD set of that relation. So first we have to find the candidate keys. So if we see AC closure will be A, C, AC can determine BE, BE will be added, and BC can determine D, D will be added. That means AC closure can determine all other attributes of that relation. But its subset, that means A closure and C closure. A closure will be A, B. C closure will be C. They cannot determine all other attributes. That means AC is a candidate key. Similarly, if we see A can be determined by B. So BC will also be a key. And BC is a candidate key as well because its subset cannot determine all other attributes. Now we will see what are prime attributes. Prime attribute will be A, B and C, and non-prime attribute will be D and E. Next we will check for first normal form. So if we see first normal form means every attribute should be simple attribute. That means there should not be any multi-valued or composite attribute. So relational DBMS does not allow multi-valued or composite attribute. That means every relation is in first normal form. Next we will check for second normal form. For second normal form, there should not be any partial dependency. Partial dependency means subset of candidate key is determining non-prime attribute. Here if we see A, it is subset of candidate key and it is determining non-prime attribute. That means this is a partial dependency. So if there is a partial dependency, the relation is not in second normal form. So the highest normal form will be first normal form. Next, we have one more example. We have a relation R with attributes A, B, C, D, E, and these are the FD set. So if we want to find the candidate key, we will see AC closure. AC closure is A, C. AC can determine BE. And BC can determine D. So D will be added. But none of its subset can determine all other attributes. So AC is the candidate key. There cannot be any more candidate key. So the only candidate key is AC. So prime attribute will be A and C. Non-prime attribute will be B, D and E. So now we will check for first normal form. As we have previously discussed, every relation is in first normal form. Now we will check for second normal form. For second normal form, there should not be any partial dependency. That means left hand side, if it is subset of candidate key, and right hand side, if it is non-prime attribute, then it will be partial dependency. If we see here BC, it is not subset of candidate key, AC not subset of candidate key, B not subset of candidate key. That means there is no partial dependency. It is in second normal form. To check for third normal form, there should not be any transitive dependency. That means a relation is in third normal form if either left hand side should be key or right hand side should be prime attribute. If we see here, left hand side is not a key, right hand side is not a prime attribute. That means this is not satisfying third normal form. Okay, so the highest normal form will be second normal form. Next, we will see one more example. We have relation R, A, B, C, D, E, and these are the FD set. So if we find closure of B, it will be B, A will be added, C will be added, and BC will determine D, and AC will determine B, so E will be added. So B will be a candidate key. So if we see B can be determined by AC, so AC can also be a key. But if we see its subset C closure can determine only C, A closure can determine A, C, B, E, D. That means candidate key will be A. So there are two candidate keys, A and B. So prime attributes will be A, B and non-prime will be C, D. So the relation will be in first normal form as always. If we want to check for second normal form means on left hand side, there should not be any subset of candidate key. B is not a subset of candidate key. A is not a subset of candidate key. BC is not subset of candidate key. AC is not subset of candidate key. That means it is in second normal form. For third normal form, either left hand side should be key or right hand side should be prime attribute. Here left hand side is a key. Here left hand side is a key. Here left hand side is a key. In every FD, left hand side is a key. So it is in third normal form. For BCNF, there is only one condition, left hand side should be a key. As we have previously checked, left hand side is a key in each and every FD. So that means the relation is in BCNF as well.